88 Magarey Medal is proudly brought to you by Mitsubishi Motors Australia Limited, Meyer Sport, WMI and Westpac.
I reckon Gilbert McAdam will surprise us all by winning the Magarey medal tonight.
Well, I think Chris McDermott's obviously going to be one of the runners. Andrew Jarman, second year in a row, you never know.
Commissioner Brian Martin, those you haven't rubbed out, have we got anyone left who could win it?
Well, that's an unfair question. Yeah, I hope so. Chris McDermott.
Chris McDermott obviously should win it.
Jarman again, perhaps, but I tend to like Whittlesea.
I think McAdam, Gilbert McAdam.
Well, I think Andrew Jarman will do well again. He had another good year after last year, and I think he can win two in a row.
Who might take it off you this year?
Chris McDermott by a mile. If he doesn't, I'll walk to China.
Welcome to the 83rd presentation of South Australia's most prestigious sporting award, the Magarey Medal. Coming to you tonight for the first time from the Adelaide Convention Centre. In a few days' time, the games of the 24th Olympiad will commence in Seoul, South Korea, and the cream of the world's athletes will be competing for Olympic gold. Tonight, the cream of South Australian footballers are in contention for football gold, the Magarey Medal, and also a place in South Australian football history. There's no doubt that over the years, the Magarey Medal presentation has become one of the most important events in South Australia's social calendar. But that was definitely not the case when the first medal was presented 90 years ago in 1898.
The medal derives its name from its donor, William Ashley Magarey, who was the then chairman of the South Australian Football Association. Magarey was a respected solicitor and noted sportsman. Although he only played football during his school days at St. Peter's College, Magarey was an amateur champion boxer, a sound lacrosse player, and represented South Australia at cricket. His reasons for instituting a medal for the fairest and most brilliant player, as determined by the field umpires, was to raise the prestige of umpires and to encourage good football, fair tactics, and attract players from the public and encourage interest in athletics and sport generally, and so improve physique and power of endeavour and spontaneous action.
Few would doubt that some 90 years later, William Ashley Magarey has achieved that goal. In a moment, be our guest for tonight's presentation of the 1988 Magarey Medal.
Nichols, oh, what a mark for Stephen Nichols!
Can he keep his 100th goal? There it is, it's a goal! It's a goal! It's his 100th!
Oh, I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds white, the bright blessed day, dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Yes, all clear. 1 point. Craig Balm in complete control, I think. A few magic moments there, and that just shows you what a wonderful game our South Australian football really is. And we wouldn't miss it for the world. And now for a man who has done more for football in this state than Louis Armstrong has done for the trumpet, our president, Mr. Max Bashir.
Your Excellency, Sir Donald Dunstan, Governor of South Australia, Mr. John Bannon, Premier of South Australia, Mr. John Olson, the Leader of the Opposition in the State Parliament, Mr. Steve Condas, the Lord Mayor of the City of Adelaide, to all past Magarey medalists, league players, league club officials and league coaches, to the umpires who've cast their votes for this year's medal, to members of the media, and also to all those of you at home who are watching this telecast, I do extend to you a warm welcome to this evening's function. And I hope that you will enjoy the telecast tonight at our wonderful convention centre here in Adelaide. I am required by the rules of the Magarey Medal Trust to inform you that this is a league official meeting and also that players who've been found guilty of a breach of the laws of the game are not eligible to win the medal. So let's hope that we can all sit back and enjoy tonight's telecast. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks, Max. I love it when Max says that this is an official meeting of the league. It just adds a touch to the evening. I've never been to a league meeting before. These are the only ones I've ever been to, Magarey Medal evenings. Great evenings. Well, earlier on this evening, the medals for the fairest and most brilliant players in the under-17s, under-19s and the league reserves have already been presented to the respective winners by SANFL Vice President Mr. Bob Lee. In the under-17s, the McCallum Medal, named after Fred McCallum, a former long-serving Norwood and League official and father of the 1936 Magarey medalist Bill McCallum, was first awarded in 1939. Congratulations to the winner of the 1988 McCallum Medal, South Adelaide's centre-half forward, Todd Baish, with 26 votes. And in the under-19s, the Tompkins Medal, named after Bill Tompkins, a former West Torrens player, official and league delegate. That medal was first awarded in 1937. We now congratulate the winner of the 1988 Tompkins Medal. He hails from West Adelaide. He is a rover. He won the award with 16 votes. We congratulate Craig Bozzo. And in the Eyewitness Cup, the league reserves Magarey medal, which is in fact a silver replica of the league medal, and that was first awarded in 1919. We congratulate the winner of the 1988 reserves Magarey medal. Port Adelaide is the club that he plays for. His name is Adrian Setri, and he won the medal with 14 votes. While we're at the Port Adelaide table, I'd like to welcome a very special guest here. He was recently a semi-finalist in the US Open at Flushing Meadow in New York, the highest placed South Australian ever in the US Open. And in a few days' time, he will depart South Australia for Seoul in Korea to represent Australia at the Olympic Games. South Australia's own Darren Cahill. Good luck, Darren. In America, they call him Cahill. In South Australia, we still call him Cale, the great Cale family. A few weeks ago, a book entitled SA Greats, The History of the Magarey Medal, was published, written by noted South Australian football historian John Wood. It features chapters on every winner of the coveted award. And it took John almost 4 years to research and complete. Tonight, we pay tribute to several past Magarey medalists. And to begin with, we feature a man regarded as one of the finest, if not the finest rover this state has ever produced. To tell you more about him, former journalist, West Adelaide and state footballer, Merv Agars.
When they begin, the begin.
The year was 1938, the year champion Port Adelaide rover Bob Quinn was to win the first of his two Magarey medals. With the outbreak of World War II the following year, Bob enlisted in the AIF and rose to the rank of lieutenant. He was wounded in the knee while serving in the siege of Tobruk and was awarded the Military Medal for Bravery. He was also wounded in an arm while serving in the Pacific. With his war injuries heavily strapped, Bob resumed his career as captain coach of Port Adelaide in 1945 and played probably his best ever football to win his second Magarey Medal by the then record margin of 18 votes.
Well, in 1936, I was favourite to win the medal, and I was beaten by 4 votes. And then, in 1937, I was a hot favourite to win it. And I was beaten by 1 vote, the last vote that came out. Drib Hawke got three votes, and he beat me by 1 vote. And then in 1938, I thought, well, I'm not going to have any people around and listen to the medal because it was too disappointing. So a very good friend of mine had a butcher shop, and we went into the butcher shop to listen to it, and he had the wireless in the cog room. So we sat down among all the carcasses and listened to the vote, and finally I won the medal, and very, very happy. But of course the being beaten in the 2 previous years learned me to take the good with the bad, and of course when it was over I then went to see my father, who was working, and told him I'd won the medal, and he said, oh well, it's about time too.
What they be. Yes, I swear, it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
Rosa, every time of my life, and I owe it all to you.
I've been waiting for so long, now I found someone to stand by me.
Yeah.
some of the very best action from season 1988. And did the 1988 Magarey medalist appear in those highlights? Well, we're about to begin to find out. This year, for the very first time, all votes will be counted during the telecast round by round. As the votes are called by our president, Mr. Max Bashir, they will be displayed on your screen in the following order. First preference worth 3 votes, second preference worth 2 votes, and third preference 1 vote. The value of the vote will awarded will automatically be added to the player's existing total, so you'll always be kept up to date by the Wang computer. League General Manager Lee Wicker is now with Max Bashir to commence the counting of the votes for rounds 1, 2 and 3. Thank you, Max.
Thank you, Peter. Round 1, West Adelaide versus Woodville. West Adelaide, Grantley Filkey, 3 votes. West Adelaide, Tony Burgess, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Kieran Spawn, 1 vote. Torrens versus South Adelaide. West Torrens, Michael Long, 3 votes. West Torrens, T. Clark, 2 votes. South Adelaide, M. Bennett, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus Sturt. Port Adelaide, B. Abernethy, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, G. Boyd, 2 votes. Sturt, J. Painter, 1 vote. Central Districts versus North Adelaide. Central Districts, J. Thomas, 3 votes. Central Districts, G. Smith, 2 votes. And Central Districts, G. McAdam, 1 vote. Norwood versus Glenelg. Glenelg, A. Stringer, 3 votes. Glenelg, T. Simons, 2 votes. And Norwood, R. Anderson, 1 vote. Round 2, West Adelaide versus West Torrens. West Adelaide, C. Lamb, 3 votes. West Adelaide, P. Winter, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, Case Bourne, 1 vote. Sturt versus Norwood. Norwood, C. Kelly, 3 votes. Norwood, S. Rowe, 2 votes. Norwood, R. Maynard, 1 vote. Glenelg versus Port Adelaide. Glenelg, Tony Simons, 3 votes. Glenelg, Alan Stringer, 2 votes. Glenelg, D. Grenvold, 1 vote. Woodville versus Central District. Central Districts, G. Smith, 3 votes. Woodville, J. Klug, 2 votes. And Centrals, G. Chapman, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus South Adelaide. North Adelaide, S. Riley, 3 votes. North Adelaide, M. Redden, 2 votes. And North Adelaide, T. Clisby, 1 vote. In round three, Norwood versus North Adelaide, Norwood, S. Rowe, 3 votes. Norwood, M. Aish, 2 votes. And Norwood, R. Anderson, 1 vote. West Adelaide versus Glenelg. Glenelg, R. Gibbs, 3 votes. Glenelg, D. Marshall, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, R. McKinnon, 1 vote. Central Districts versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 3 votes. Central Districts, G. Smith, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, D. Smith, 1 vote. West Torrens versus Woodville. West Torrens, M. Long, 3 votes. West Torrens, K. Taylor, 2 votes. And Woodville, A. Lunn, 1 vote. South Adelaide versus Sturt. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, S. Russell, 2 votes. And Sturt, L. Shackey, 1 vote. That completes the first 3 rounds.
Yes, thank you, Max. Well, you might notice when looking at those votes that there is a little asterisk which appears alongside some names. That, of course, means that players have incurred the wrath of the umpires and have spent an uncomfortable Monday evening with Brian Martin, QC. Poor old Brian's had a pretty tough time of it this year. He hasn't spent a Monday night at home. So the leading players there, Michael Long, ineligible, 6 votes. Tony Simons and Greg Smith and also Alan Stringer there with 5 votes. But we'll check the leaderboard a little bit later with Graham Campbell. You wouldn't normally associate qualities such as spectacular, high leaping, dashing, to apply to a full-back. But for one such man, such superlatives were justified. To tell you more, former Norwood and State ruckman, Pat Hall.
It was in 1950, the year that saw the North Adelaide captain, Ian McKay, become the first full-back to win a Magarey medal. Ian was captain of North from 48 to 55, I believe a club record, and during this time, he led the club to 2 premiership wins, in 1949 and 52. The latter being memorable for 2 reasons. The size of their victory, a record 18 goals, and the fact he dug his knees into my shoulder blades and took the best mark I ever felt.
Well, it was about 10 minutes into the last quarter, and being so far in front, there hadn't been much play in my back full-back position, so I thought I'd have a run on the ball. And the ball was coming round the grandstand flank, and Pat Hall and I were jostling for positions, and eventually I had a chance to get a run in and climbed up Pat's back and took the mark. And fortunately, the cameraman happened to be on the spot, and it was recorded in the Sunday Mail. And the caption was Mark of the Year. And of course, I was very proud of that. And what put the cream on the cake was the fact that I managed to kick a goal from that mark.
Sing this song to you. What are we saying? Old acquaintance, be forgot.
Yeah, Neville Roberts there, showing that since his retirement from league football and his entry into the media as a commentator, the Big Rock has become completely unbiased and impartial. And I'm sure you'll agree that after hearing that, Frank Sinatra has absolutely nothing to worry about. The SANFL scrutineers have confirmed that the voting is in order, and here's a bit of a surprise in the voting from another famous warbler, the Oracle himself, Graham Campbell.
Thanks for that, Peter. Well, they tell me Michael Long's leading. Greg Smith leading with 7. Michael Long, I believe, also has 5, and both those guys, unfortunately, have been rubbed out this year, as Peter's already told you. Tony Simon's on 5, the guy that is out injured at this point in time from Glenelg. Alan Stringer also on 5 from Glenelg. A real traffic jam, Peter, really. Stephen Rowe, Norwood Rover, also on 5. And Ross Gibbs, the erstwhile back pocket player from Glenelg, on 3, with many other players also on 3.
Thank you, Graham. And to count the votes for rounds 4, 5 and 6, Max Bashir.
Thank you, Peter. Round 4, Glenelg versus Sturt. Sturt, A. Underwood, 3 points. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 2 points. And Sturt, L. Shackey, 1 point. South Adelaide versus West Adelaide. South Adelaide, M. Bennett, 3. South Adelaide, P. Brooksby, 2. And West Adelaide, G. Goss, 1. Central District versus West Torrens. Central District, D. Kickett, 3. Central District, G. Chaplin, 2. Central District, G. McAdam, 1. Norwood versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, G. Fiacci, 3. Norwood, P. Hall, J. Hall, 2. And Norwood, J. Scanlon, 1. North Adelaide versus Woodville. North Adelaide, S. Riley, 3. North Adelaide, T. Clisby, 2. And North Adelaide, S. Sims, 1. In round 5, South Adelaide versus Central District. South Adelaide, Michael Bennett, 3 votes. Central District, G. Chaplin, 2 votes. And Central District, R. Van Dommel, 1 vote. Sturt versus West Torrens. West Torrens, D. Fotier, 3 votes. West Torrens, I. Hannah, 2 votes. And West Torrens, P. Weston, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, A. Jarman, 3 votes. North Adelaide, D. Jarman, 2 votes. And North Adelaide, S. Riley, 1 vote. West Adelaide versus Norwood. Norwood, T. Francis, 3 votes. Norwood, R. Maynard, 2 votes. And Norwood, J. Antochia, 1 vote. Woodville versus Glenelg. Glenelg, A. Stringer, 3 votes. Glenelg, C. Buterick, 2 votes. And Glenelg, P. Carey, 1 vote. In round 6, West Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, D. Brown, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, B. Abernethy, 2 votes. and West Adelaide Case Bourne, one vote. Woodville versus Sturt. Woodville, M. Templeton, three votes. Sturt, Kim Russell, two votes. And Woodville, Kevin Harris, one vote. West Torrens versus North Adelaide. West Torrens, S. Geyer, three votes. West Torrens, D. Christensen, two votes. And North Adelaide, J. Riley, one vote. Glenelg versus Central Districts. Glenelg, A. Stringer, three votes. Glenelg, P. Maynard, two votes. And Glenelg, Ross Gibbs, one vote. South Adelaide versus Norwood. Norwood, T. Francis, three votes. Norwood, R. Anderson, two votes. And Norwood, S. Rowe, one vote. That completes round six.
Yes, thank you, Max. Well, pretty exciting situation at the moment, but do remember these votes are being counted round by round. The runaway leader at the moment, on my reckoning, is Glenelg's Alan Stringer, and you can see the others following there, Alan Stringer by some four votes. We'll check the leaders with Graham Campbell shortly. And speaking of former Victorians, our next feature past medalist was undoubtedly the best Victorian player to transfer to this state. And the fact that he was chosen in the Collingwood all-time champion team was quite an achievement, considering he played his first game for the Woods when he was 15 and his last game for the Woods when he was 21 years of age. To tell you more, here's a man who gave him very many votes, former umpire Max Hall.
Do not forsake me, oh my darling.
Len Fitzgerald was an absolute football freak. Len holds the unique distinction of winning three Magarey medals from three different positions. 1952 at centre-half back, 1954 as a ruck rover, and in 1959, note that date, at centre-half forward. He began his career with Collingwood at the tender age of 15, played 97 games for the Magpies and represented Victoria twice. Len transferred to Sturt in 1951 and was appointed captain after only three games with his new club. He coached the Blues from 1952 to 1955. Fitzy spent 3 years coaching Benalla in the Ovens and Murray League before resuming with Sturt in 1959 to win his third Magarey medal at 30 years of age.
Well, I was going to bed actually, and the wife was listening to the radio, and she ran in and gave me the good news. And later on, one of the television stations rang me up and asked me to come in for an interview. I think I was probably the first Magarey medal to be interviewed on TV.
All champions of Australia with a resounding victory over Victoria. The first time ever in our history that we have beaten the Big V in three successive years, beating the previous best of back-to-back victories in 1951 and 1952. A truly grand achievement. To recap, the position after round six, here's Graham Campbell.
Thanks again, Peter. Well, after six rounds, Glenelg centre man Alan Stringer has cleared out with a handy lead. He has 11 votes. He leads from Stephen Riley of North Adelaide on seven, with Michael Bennett of South Adelaide also on seven. Greg Smith, Central District, the early leader, has dropped back to equal second now, also on seven votes. Michael Long and Stephen Rowe are clustered on equal fourth position with six votes each.
And now back to Max to count the votes for round seven, eight and nine.
Round seven, Glenelg versus West Torrens. Glenelg, J. Seabone, three votes. Glenelg, J. Sneebickler, two votes. West Torrens, I. Hanna, one vote. South Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, G. Fiacci, three votes. South Adelaide, M. Bennett, two votes. Port Adelaide, S. Hodges, 1 vote. Norwood versus Woodville. Norwood, M. Aish, 3 votes. Norwood, S. Rowe, 2 votes. And Norwood, C. Kelly, 1 vote. West Adelaide versus Central Districts. Central Districts, S. Lee, 3 votes. Central Districts, P. Bubner, 2 votes. And Central Districts, G. McAdam, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus Sturt. Sturt, R. Popplestone, 3 votes. North Adelaide, Darren Jarman, 2 votes. And Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 1 vote. In round 8, Woodville versus South Adelaide. Woodville, R. Negri, 3 votes. Woodville, D. O'Dwyer, 2 votes. And Woodville, S. Nichols, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus West Torrens. Port Adelaide, G. Fiacci, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, S. Hodges, 2 votes. And West Torrens, M. Long, 1 vote. Central District versus Norwood. Central District, S. Lee, 3 votes. Central District, M. Pryor, 2 votes. And Central District, G. McAdam, 1 vote. Sturt versus West Adelaide. Sturt, Kim Russell, 3 votes. Sturt, Scott Russell, 2 votes. And Sturt, A. Downs, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus Glenelg. Glenelg, P. Carey, 3 votes. North Adelaide, P. Bennett, 2 votes. And Glenelg, G. Winton, 1 vote. In round 9, West Torrens versus South Adelaide. West Torrens, D. Fotia, 3 votes. West Torrens, D. Cox, 2 votes. And West Torrens, D. Neiman, 1 vote. Sturt versus Port Adelaide. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, D. Kitsky, 2 votes. Sturt, I. Wilmot, 1 vote. Norwood versus Glenelg. Norwood, G. McIntosh, 3 votes. Norwood, S. Rowe, 2 votes. And Norwood, T. Payne, 1 vote. West Adelaide versus Woodville. Woodville, K. Harris, 3 votes. Woodville, West Adelaide, G. Filkey, 2 votes. And Woodville, D. Grant, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus Central District. Central District, D. Kickett, 3 votes. North Adelaide, N. Craig, 2 votes. And Central District, G. McAdam, 1 vote. That completes round 9.
Yes, thank you very much, Max. So after 9 rounds, it would appear that the leader still is Alan Stringer. Graham Campbell will check the leaders in just a moment. There's a lot of talk these days that too much of the good solid bumps and body contact is being umpired out of the game. Everybody has agreed that violent and brutal acts of aggression must be eliminated. But I doubt if we will ever be able to eradicate the biffs, the bangs and the backhanders, because after all, boys will be boys.
The year was 1961, a year which proved fourth time lucky for our Sturt's co-jack, John Halbert. He began his career with the Blues in 55 as a 17-year-old. You had hair then. He earned state selection his first season, as well as finishing runner-up in the Magarey medal. He was a bridesmaid again, though, in 58 and 60. But combined with his medal success in 61, John the Baptist was also chosen on the All-Australian side, represented the state in cricket. Was chosen as District Cricketer of the Year, which is now the Bradman Medal, all in the same season.
Well, in those days, of course, they used to present the Magarey Medal on Grand Final Day on Adelaide Oval. And the thing I remember about that day is that it was an extremely hot day. The temperature was somewhere about 95 degrees. And when I walked onto the ground to receive the medal from the then Governor, Sir Edric Bastian, I wasn't sure with my cricket background whether I should ask him for middle and leg or whether I should tell him I was bowling right arm over.
It just wasn't cricket, even though it definitely was cricket weather that day. Our thanks to former Sturt and state runner Dave Daffy Duck Edwards for telling us all about gentleman Jack Halbert. Well, they say the times change, but people don't. And looking at this vision, I'm not so sure anymore. Do you recognise this man? In fact, it's none other than John Halbert, with hair. He is living proof that the passage of time has seen the hair on John Halbert's head just slide down a little bit to the sides of his face. But well done, Jack. My time will come, I suppose. After round 9, the voting is all in order. Graham Campbell.
Yes, Peter, after 9 rounds, there's a real traffic jam on the leaderboard. Alan Stringer still leads by 1 point only. And Stephen Rowe, George Fiacci, Michael Bennett and Greg Whittlesea on 9 points each, equals 6. Greg Smith, Stephen Riley and Michael Long on 7.
Now back to the action with Max Bashir. The votes for rounds 10, 11 and 12.
Round 10, Woodville versus Port Adelaide. Woodville, C. McDonald, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, G. Fiacci, 2 votes. And Woodville, R. Negri, 1 vote. Glenelg versus South Adelaide. Glenelg, J. Sneebickler, 3 votes. Glenelg, S. Salisbury, 2 votes. And Glenelg, G. Christie, 1 vote. West Torrens versus Norwood. Norwood, S. Rowe, 3 votes. West Torrens, A. Pays, 2 votes. And Norwood, B. Claiby, 1 vote. Central District versus Sturt. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, D. Willsby, 2 votes. And Central District, P. Bubner, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus West Adelaide. North Adelaide, A. Jarman, 3 votes. North Adelaide, Craig, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, C. Lamb, 1 vote. In round 11, West Torrens versus West Adelaide. West Torrens, T. Clark, 3 votes. West Torrens, M. Long, 2 votes. And West Torrens, F. Spiel, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus Glenelg. Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, S. Williams, 2 votes. And Glenelg, R. Gibbs, 1 vote. Central Districts versus Woodville. Central Districts, G. McAdam, 3 votes. Central Districts, G. Chaplin, 2 votes. And Woodville, D. O'Dwyer, 1 vote. South Adelaide versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, P. Bennett, 3 votes. North Adelaide, A. Jarman, 2 votes. And North Adelaide, N. Craig, 1 vote. Sturt versus Norwood. Norwood, M. Aish, 3 votes. Norwood, T. Francis, 2 votes. And Norwood, R. Maynard, 1 vote. In round 12, Sturt versus South Adelaide. Sturt, A. Machini, 3 votes. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 2 votes. And Sturt, C. Delina, 1 vote. Woodville versus West Torrens. Woodville, R. Champion, 3 votes. Woodville, S. Reckner, 2 votes. And Woodville, D. O'Dwyer, 1 vote. Central District versus Port Adelaide. Central District, P. Graham, 3 votes. Central District, G. Smith, 2 votes. And Central District, G. McAdam, 1 vote. Glenelg versus West Adelaide. West Adelaide, K. Spawn, 3 votes. West Adelaide, G. Filkey, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, C. Lamb, 1 vote. Norwood versus North Adelaide. Norwood, C. Kelly, 3 votes. North Adelaide, A. Jarman, 2 votes. And North Adelaide, C. Burton, 1 vote. That completes round 12.
And so we are just one round past the halfway point, and we have a new leader, Greg Whittlesea from the Sturt Football Club, on 14 points. As tonight is a night when we honour all that is fairest and most brilliant, here's something that is simply irresistible.
She's a queen. 1928. A year which saw Glenelg centre halfback Jim Hamby become the club's first Magarey medalist. Jim began his career with South Adelaide in 1922, but switched to Glenelg in 1925. And by a strange coincidence, Jim's first game for his new club was also their first win in league football after 56 consecutive losses. Jim was captain coach of Glenelg in 1926 and 27, and again in 1930, 31, and 32.
Well, in those days, the Magarey medal votes were counted in the league rooms by the league delegates. There was no radio or television coverage. There was no special functions or events to mark the occasion. Ern Ruggles, who was secretary of the Glenelg Football Club at that time and a league delegate, after the count rang me up and said, "Jim, congratulations, you won the Magarey medal." I went into the lounge and I said to the wife, "Ern Ruggles has just rang and said I won the Magarey medal." She said, "That's wonderful. That calls for a celebration." I said, "It sure does." She said, "Good. I'll make a cup of tea and we'll have a tomato sandwich." And that's how we celebrated.
Tomato sandwich. Our thanks to former Glenelg player and coach Stan Wickham for those reflections on Jim Hamby. And 60 years after his great Magarey medal win, it's really great to welcome the 1928 Magarey medalist here tonight, Big Jim Hamby. After round 12, let's check the leaderboard with Graham Campbell.
Yes, thank you, Peter. Well, Sturt captain Greg Whittlesea leads on 14 points. Second is Stephen Rowan, 13. Alan Stringer and George Fiacci equal third on 11. Andrew Jarman comes next with 10. And remarkably, Gilbert McAdam, who has voted in 7 out of the 12 games, is equal sixth on 9 votes.
Let's get right back into the count now for rounds 13, 14 and 15. Max Bashir.
Round 13, Port Adelaide versus Norwood. Port Adelaide, R. Delaney, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 2 votes. And Norwood, G. McIntosh, 1 vote. Sturt versus Glenelg. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, S. Field, 2 votes. Glenelg, C. McDermott, 1 vote. Woodville versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, M. Redden, 3 votes. North Adelaide, N. Craig, 2 votes. And Woodville, D. O'Dwyer, 1 vote. West Adelaide versus South Adelaide. West Adelaide, D. Toomey, 3 votes. South Adelaide, C. Dewhurst, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, C. Lamb, 1 vote. West Torrens versus Central Districts. Central Districts, P. Bubner, 3 votes. Central Districts, G. McAdam, 2 votes. And West Torrens, M. Long, 1 vote. Round 14, West Torrens versus Sturt. Sturt, L. Shackey, 3 votes. Sturt, P. McWilliam, 2 votes. And West Torrens, D. Christensen, 1 vote. Glenelg versus Woodville. Woodville, R. Negri, 3 votes. Glenelg, C. McDermott, 2 votes. And Glenelg, T. McTavish, 1 vote. Central Districts versus South Adelaide. Central Districts, R. Handley, 3 votes. Central Districts, D. Kickett, 2 votes. And Central Districts, G. Smith, 1 vote. Norwood versus West Adelaide. Norwood, T. McNeil, 3 votes. West Adelaide, R. McKinnon, 2 votes. And Norwood, R. Maynard, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, S. Williams, 3 votes. North Adelaide, A. Jarman, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 1 vote. In round 15, Central Districts versus Glenelg. Central Districts, G. McAdam, 3 votes. Central Districts, P. Bubner, 2 votes. Glenelg, D. Grenvold, 1 vote. South Adelaide versus Norwood. Norwood, S. Rowe, 3 votes. Norwood, S. Richardson, 2 votes. And South Adelaide, C. Dewhurst, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus West Adelaide. West Adelaide, R. McKinnon, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, A. Kennedy, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, R. Bennett, 1 vote. Woodville versus Sturt. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, S. Russell, 2 votes. Woodville, R. Negri, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus West Torrens. West Torrens, F. Spiel, 3 votes. North Adelaide, P. Bennett, 2 votes. And North Adelaide, J. Rowe, 1 vote. And that completes round 15.
Thank you very much, Max. So with just 7 rounds still to be counted, we still have Sturt captain Greg Whittlesea as the leader on 20 points. You know, in football, there's nothing that stirs the emotion of all players, supporters and officials more than a grand final. It takes over 9 months of sweat, toil, training, up to 4 and 5 nights a week just to make it to that one final day. To achieve premiership victory requires the harnessing of all the qualities of teamwork, comradeship, mateship, determination and the all-important element of luck. After finishing minor premiers for 3 successive years, last year North Adelaide avenged the humiliation of 2 grand final losses, lifted the monkey from its back and crowned itself in premiership glory in truly grand style. Here's a well-known South Australian who has the ability to crystallise all of the elements of grand final emotions in words and music.
I guess football, there's nothing bigger than the grand final day, you know, giving the players the opportunity to get in front of an audience or a crowd like 50,000 people who just want the best out of them. I know that being an entertainer, I've been in a similar position myself, and probably not as violent. it's going to be a great day at Football Park, and, you know, I'm a local lad, I follow football, so it's great. I'm a bit of a Port supporter, and I believe John Cale's back at Port, so let's go for it, lads.
Screen door slam, you were gone.
Having something like that happen to you would almost make Daisy want to tear his hair out. On Saturday, one team will earn a one-way ticket into this year's grand final and a chance to win football's ultimate prize, the Premiership. Who will win football's ultimate individual prize, the Magarey medal? We'll continue the countdown in just a moment. '88 Magarey medal presentation. Well, the count is certainly at a very interesting stage indeed. We have Greg Whittlesea, the Sturt captain, leading with 20 votes. Roe from Norwood on 16. And Gilbert McAdam is on 14. And Andrew Jarman is on 12 votes. We're going to get right back into the action now and keep the count rolling on. And to count the votes for rounds 16, 17 and 18, once again, Mr. Max Bashir.
Round 16, Central District versus West Adelaide. Central District, S. Lee, 3 votes. West Adelaide, C. Lamb, 2 votes. And Central District's G. McAdam, 1 vote. Sturt versus North Adelaide. Sturt, J. Painter, 3 votes. North Adelaide, M. Redden, 2 votes. And Sturt, R. Popplestone, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus South Adelaide. Port Adelaide, R. Kerr, 3 votes. South Adelaide, N. Smart, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 1 vote. West Torrens versus Glenelg. West Torrens, M. Long, 3 votes. West Torrens, L. Robson, 2 votes. and West Torrens I Hannah, one vote. Woodville versus Norwood. Woodville, R. Negri, three votes. Woodville, D. O'Dwyer, two votes. And Woodville, K. Harris, one vote. In round 17, West Torrens versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, B. Abernethy, three votes. West Torrens, R. Enright, two votes. And West Torrens, T. Clark, one vote. South Adelaide versus Woodville. Woodville, R. Champion, three votes. South Adelaide, S. Butler, two votes. And South Adelaide, D. Baker, one vote. Norwood versus Central Districts. Norwood, C. Kelly, three votes. Norwood, J. Scanlon, two votes. And Norwood, G. McIntosh, one vote. West Adelaide versus Sturt. West Adelaide, C. Lamb, three votes. West Adelaide, P. Patterson, two votes. And West Adelaide, A. Burgess, one vote. North Adelaide versus Glenelg. Glenelg, J. West, three votes. Glenelg, C. McDermott, two votes. And Glenelg, K. Hodgman, one vote. In round 18, Woodville versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, M. Wharton, three votes. Port Adelaide, G. Phillips, two votes. And Port Adelaide, G. Fiacci, one vote. Norwood versus West Torrens. Norwood, G. McIntosh, three votes. Norwood, M. Ducker, two votes. And Norwood, D. Payne, one vote. Central Districts versus Sturt. Central Districts, S. Schwert, three votes. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, two votes. Central Districts, J. Thomas, one vote. North Adelaide versus West Adelaide. North Adelaide, C. Burton, three votes. North Adelaide, D. Cooch, two votes. And West Adelaide, G. Filkey, one vote. Glenelg versus South Adelaide. Glenelg, A. Stringer, three votes. Glenelg, C. McDermott, two votes. And Glenelg, T. McTavish, one vote. And that completes the counting of round 18.
Thank you, Max. The count's certainly at a very exciting stage. With only four rounds to go, Sturt captain Greg Whittlesea has a six-point lead. The count...
The year was 1978, and what a year that was for our cheeky rover, Kimmy Hodgman. In the first full year of the two-umpire system, Hodgie polled a then-record 50 votes, beating Port captain Russell Ebert by just one vote. Now, it proved his 1974 reserve Magarey medal was merely a sign of things to come. I guess the worst thing about winning the Magarey medal is knowing that you have to make an acceptance speech in front of all those people. Now, you know you have to say something, anything, And that is exactly what Hodgie did.
I'd like to thank the coach, all the Glenelg officials. It's been a tremendous year. I'd also like to thank my parents, especially Mum and Dad. Sorry about that. Mum and Dad.
I'm sure they're the only two.
I don't know what I'm talking about, you see.
And a word of advice to this year's Magarey medalist, whoever he may be. You now know what not to say in your acceptance speech. Voting all checks out at the end of round 18. Here's Graham Campbell.
Well, Peter, it seems like Sturt captain Greg Whittlesea has an unbreakable lead on this year's medal. 22 votes. He leads Stephen Rowe by 6 votes. Rowe is 1 point in front of Gilbert McAdam on 15, Alan Stringer on 14, Michael Long 13, and last year's winner, Andrew Jarman, on 12 votes.
Well, a lot can happen in the last four rounds, and to count the votes for rounds 19, 20, 21 and 22, again, Max Bashir.
Round 19, West Adelaide versus Woodville. Woodville, S. Nichols, 3 votes. West Adelaide, R. Lorby, 2 votes. And Woodville, P. Schwarz, 1 vote. South Adelaide versus West Torrens. West Torrens, A. Bays, 3 votes. South Adelaide, M. Brooks, 2 votes. And West Torrens, M. Edmonds, 1 vote. Glenelg versus Norwood. Glenelg, W. Stringer, 3 votes. Glenelg, C. McDermott, 2 votes. And Glenelg, G. Christie, 1 vote. Central Districts versus North Adelaide. Central Districts, G. McCallum, 3 votes. Central Districts, S. Lally, 2 votes. And Central Districts, P. Sullivan, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus Sturt. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, J. Painter, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 1 vote. In round 20, West Adelaide versus West Torrens. West Torrens, M. Long, 3 votes. West Adelaide, D. Toomey, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, K. Spawn, 1 vote. Norwood versus Sturt. Norwood, G. McIntosh, 3 votes. Norwood, R. Maynard, 2 votes. And Norwood, C. Kelly, 1 vote.
Out at the end of round 18, here's Graham Campbell.
Well, Peter, it seems like Sturt captain Greg Whittlesea has an unbreakable lead on this year's medal. 22 votes. He leads Stephen Rowe by 6 votes. Rowe is 1 point in front of Gilbert McAdam on 15, Alan Stringer on 14, Michael Long 13, and last year's winner, Andrew Jarman, on 12 votes.
Well, a lot can happen in the last four rounds, and to count the votes for rounds 19, 20, 21 and 22, again, Max Bashir.
Round 19, West Adelaide versus Woodville. Woodville, S. Nichols, 3 votes. West Adelaide, R. Lorby, 2 votes. And Woodville, P. Schwarz, 1 vote. South Adelaide versus West Torrens. West Torrens, A. Pace, 3 votes. South Adelaide, M. Brooks, 2 votes. And West Torrens, M. Edmonds, 1 vote. Glenelg versus Norwood. Glenelg, W. Stringer, 3 votes. Glenelg, C. McDermott, 2 votes. And Glenelg, G. Christie, 1 vote. Central Districts versus North Adelaide. Central Districts, G. McAdam, 3 votes. Central Districts, S. Lally, 2 votes. And Central Districts, P. Sullivan, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus Sturt. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, J. Painter, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 1 vote. In round 20, West Adelaide versus West Torrens. West Torrens, M. Long, 3 votes. West Adelaide, D. Toomey, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, K. Spawn, 1 vote. Norwood versus Sturt. Norwood, G. McIntosh, 3 votes. Norwood, R. Maynard, 2 votes. And Norwood, C. Kelly, 1 vote. Central Districts versus Woodville. Woodville, R. Negri, 3 votes. Woodville, J. Klug, 2 votes. And Woodville, M. Templeton, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus Glenelg. Glenelg, C. McDermott, 3 votes. Glenelg, N. Chigwidden, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, R. Delaney, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, S. Butler, 3 votes. South Adelaide, P. Brooksby, 2 votes. And North Adelaide, S. Hamilton, 1 vote. In round 21, West Torrens versus Woodville. West Torrens, D. Foote, 3 votes. Woodville, A. Lunn, 2 votes. West Torrens, B. Lindsay, 1 vote. Glenelg versus West Adelaide. West Adelaide, C. Lamb, 3 votes. Glenelg, T. McTavish, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, A. Burgess, 1 vote. Port Adelaide versus Central Districts. Port Adelaide, S. Williams, 3 votes. Port Adelaide, M. Leslie, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, T. Ginever, 1 vote. North Adelaide versus Norwood. Norwood, J. Hall, 3 votes. North Adelaide, P. Bennett, 2 votes. And Norwood, J. Thorpe, 1 vote. Sturt versus South Adelaide. Sturt, G. Whittlesea, 3 votes. Sturt, C. Delina, 2 votes. South Adelaide, N. Smart, 1 vote. In round 22, West Adelaide versus South Adelaide. West Adelaide, G. Filkey, 3 votes. South Adelaide, D. Renfrey, 2 votes. West Adelaide, A. Burgess, 1 vote. West Torrens versus Central Districts. Central Districts, P. Bubner, 3 votes. Central Districts, P. Sullivan, 2 votes. and West Torrens, M. Long, one vote. Glenelg versus Sturt, Glenelg, D. Marshall, three votes. Glenelg, C. McDermott, two votes. Glenelg, A. Stringer, one vote. North Adelaide versus Woodville. Woodville, R. Negri, three votes. Woodville, D. Panizza, two votes. And Woodville, S. Nichols, one vote. Port Adelaide versus Norwood. Norwood, J. Hall, three votes. Norwood, G. McIntosh, two votes. And the last vote is to Norwood, M. Ducker, one vote. And that completes the voting.
We will have to wait for confirmation from our scrutineers before we officially announce the medal. I'm sure that confirmation won't take too long. Or will it? Yes, we do have it. We have confirmation, and I'll now invite SANFL President Mr. Max Bashir to come to the stand to make the official announcement.
Thank you, Peter. I have very much pleasure in announcing that the winner of the 1988 Magarey Medal in this our bicentennial year is Sturt's captain Greg Whittlesea. My pleasure to extend to Greg the congratulations of all of the league clubs and also the football public of South Australia. He's had a marvellous season for Sturt and for the state, and the decision that Greg made to tear up that plane ticket to Melbourne has certainly been vindicated, because by so doing he's not only joined the player retention scheme, but tonight's win adds another $10,000 to it. And so that's very well and truly worthwhile. But Greg is an ornament to the game, has played the game fairly at all times, and I don't think there's anyone here or anywhere else that would say other than, well done, Greg, you thoroughly deserve the medal. Congratulations.
First of all, I'd just like to thank the Sturt Footy Club for letting me play league footy. Great tradition. It's a proud club. I'm glad that I'm a part of it. And to the players, Merv, the board, everybody back at Sturt, they're a great club, and I'm very proud to be playing for them. My parents, I've got to thank them. You know, they've supported me in the background. Dad's home on the farm. He hadn't pressured me into any decision and what I made, and I'm thankful for that. And I'm glad, I hope they'll be proud of me, I think they will be, and everybody back in Yankalilla in the hometown. Chris McDermott, you need a double blue Guernsey on, mate. I reckon you'll follow from my advice, but no. I think the state respects you as a great player, captain of the state, and to the four sides left in the finals, all the best. It's a great competition this year with six pretty even sides, and anybody can win the grand final from here. Unfortunately, we weren't good enough yesterday, but we'll be better off with the experience, and just look out for us next year. Thanks a lot.
Greg, you've said it all. There is nothing left to be said. What we will do, though, is we will pay a tribute to the runner-up, a man that polled in, I don't know how many games he polled in, but certainly quite a few. Gilbert McAdam from the Central District Football Club with 18 votes. Michael Long was third on 17, although he was ineligible, along with Romano Negri on 17. Stephen Rowe from Norwood with 16, and then Alan Stringer with 15 votes. So congratulations once again to the 1988 Magarey medalist, Greg Whittlesea, captain of the Sturt Football Club. And gentlemen, as we bid you good night from the Adelaide Convention Centre, I give you the 1988 Magarey medalist, Greg Whittlesea.